Hi everyone. Okay, so in this session, we will continue the ILD for trust structures. Okay, so in your previous lecture, I have explained in detail how we can develop the ILD for the trust structures in the example 6. Okay, so this is the influence line diagram for member BG. Okay, so in the example 7, we will apply the real load. Okay, which is the vehicle loads on the truss structures, and we will use this ILD diagram, okay, to calculate the maximum compressive force and the maximum tension force in the example 7 and example 8 respectively. Okay, so let's start with example 7. Okay, so in example 7, we need to calculate the maximum compressive force developed in the member BG of the bridge shown due to the right side wheel loads of the truck. Okay, take the distance between the front wheel and the rear wheel is 2 meter, where you can see in this diagram. So this is a vehicle where the distance between the front and the rear wheels is 2 meter. Assume the loads are applied directly to the truss and move only to the right. Okay, so in this problem, you can see that the vehicle is moved from joint A to, I mean that the support A to support E. So from left to the right. Okay, so and you can see obviously that the wheel load is equal to 5 kN each. Okay, so and based on this vehicle's load applied, okay, so we are required to calculate the value of maximum compressive force. Okay, basically, before you can answer this particular question, so actually, you need to develop the ILD diagram for the truss in the member BG. Okay, so basically, actually, we have done in example 6, we have developed the ILD in example 6, where you can see in this slide. Okay, so this is the ILD for member BG. Okay, so in the example 7, we will apply the real load, the actual load, okay, in the ILD diagram, okay, for member BG, since in the example 7 stated that the in the member BG. So if the questions, let's say the questions change to member GD or member DF, so you need to develop the new ILD for the member GD and the member DF. Okay, so you can't to use this particular diagram. Okay, since in this example, so the member BG has been stated in this example 7. So you can use this particular diagram, ILD diagram. Okay, so basically in the examinations, okay, so the real load will be indicated in the diagram. Okay, so actually you can't to use this particular load directly. So you need to develop the ILD diagram first. So by applying the 1 unit load on the structure system, so whether it is a beam or a truss. Okay, so once we have developed the ILD diagram, then you can apply the real load or the vehicle load on the structure system or on the ILD diagram. Okay, so don't be confused. So at first you need to remove the actual or the vehicle load on the diagram. So you need to apply 1 unit load to develop the ILD diagram. So then after that you can apply the real load to answer the question. I mean that if the question asking about the maximum bending moment, the maximum shear force, or the maximum for the stress case, usually is referred to maximum compressive force. Sometimes it can be referred to maximum tension force. Okay, I hope that you can grab that when you deal with the equation in the test or in the final exam. Okay, so let's be return to this example 7. Okay, so the ILD has been developed. Okay, now we want focus on how we can apply this particular real or vehicle load in the ILD diagram to get the maximum compressive force. So we know that the condition is where this vehicle is moved from left to the right. Okay, so where you can see in this diagram. Okay, so the vehicle is moved from these points of joint A towards the joint E. So the movement is from left to right. Okay. So in this diagram, you can see that I have mentioned in the previous lecture, this is the tension side. So this is a compression side. So in the questions, I mentioned that we need to calculate the maximum compressor force. So due to that, you need to place this particular vehicle load on the this side, which is a compressive side of force. Okay. So since the questions mentioned the maximum value, so you need to place this particular vehicle load to get the maximum value of a compressive force for member BG. Okay. So so it can be like this. So you may to get a maximum value of a compressive force in a member BG by putting the vehicle in this position. Okay, so let's say this is a position. Okay, so the next, you can calculate the value of FBG by multiplying the wheel load with the corresponding factor. So the factor is referred to the vertical axis. For instance, here you can see that the rear wheel, so this is a rear wheel, this is a front wheel. So the rear wheels, which is a 5 kN multiplied with a negative 0.707. Okay, and then the front wheel, which is a 5 kN also, which multiply with the this factor. So it's about 0.4 or 0.5, something like that. Okay, so and add up both of these of this product, which is a 5 multiplied by this value, and for the rear wheel, and this front wheel multiplied by this value of 0 point something, and add up both of this product, and you will get the value of internal maximum internal forces for member BG. Okay, so that is for the example 7. Okay, so let's we take a look on example 8. So in this example 8, we need to calculate the maximum tension force in the member BG. So, and again, in the member BG, it's the same structure system. So the ILD remain the same. You can reuse this ILD in example 6. Okay, since the same structure system and the same member has been considered in this particular example 8. But you can see that the vehicle's load has been changed. Okay, where in example 7, we have a two wheel load of a vehicle, but here we have a three wheel load. Okay, so and this vehicles is moved from right to left, okay, from E to E. Okay, that has been mentioned in this question. Okay, so since the question asking about a maximum tension force, you need to place this vehicle load on the tension side. So the tension side is around here, okay, from 0 to 8 meters. Okay, so meaning that you need to place this vehicle to get the maximum value of maximum tension force in a member BG. Okay, so this is a front wheel, so this is an intermediate wheel, this is a rear wheel. Okay, so if you place at this position, you can see that the intermediate and the rear wheels fall down on the tensions, the compression side of the diagram in the ILD. So meaning that this particular position, it will not give the maximum value of tension for the member BG. So you need to ensure that all the loads must be fall down on the compression region of ILD diagram. Okay, so you need to get a corresponding value of factor based on each wheel, okay, by offset the value of a load towards these lines and offset to this and offset to the vertical axis, and you will get the corresponding value of factor for each load, and you can add up all the product of load with a factor. And by that, you can get the value of maximum tension in the truss, okay, in the member BG. Okay, let's say I change the equation to ache, where the vehicles move from the A to E, which is the movement of this vehicle is from to the right. Okay, so let's say I'm changing. This vehicle is moved from left to right. Okay, so the difference value of maximum tension will be obtained based on this movement. So you need to bear in mind in equations you need to be careful on the movement of the vehicle from left to right or right to left. So the different movement of a vehicle in the diagram will give different value of maximum tension or maximum compression. Okay, for instance, here let's say we change that this vehicle is moved to the right. Okay, so you can see that the front wheel will fall down at the peak point. Okay, so but if I'm considering that the vehicle is moved from right to left, so you can see I come to place that the front wheel on this peak point to get the maximum value, because the other two wheel, which is the intermediate and the rear wheel, is not in the tension side. Okay, so this is the position where the maximum value of tension of member BG can be obtained. Okay, so if in this position, okay, so maybe this is a position to get the maximum value of tensions. Okay, so I hope that you can identify the value of tensions in the member BG, so by yourself. Okay, so I think that's it for this sessions. I hope that you can apply this in the exercise that I will give assigned later in the Google Classroom. Okay, so thank you for listening.